Let's see today how to easily deploy a microservices architecture to AWS ECS and automate it from a CI/CD platform. I've already shown in another video about deploying a simple application to AWS EC2, but when deploying a microservice architecture, I need something more advanced. What must I take into account when deploying a microservices architecture? High availability, server's amount differs from microservices amount, and deploy strategies. The high availability allows me to run many instances of a service to distribute the load. This is also called the horizontal scaling. When more requests reach some of my microservices, I can create a new instance to distribute the load. I must also take into account that some new instances may be created dynamically. This means it must adapt the number of servers. Depending on the created instance, it may need more or less CPU reservation. It may need to start a new server, or the new instance can use the remaining CPU. My architecture must be smart enough to start a new server if the resources are insufficient, or shut down a server if there are too many unused resources. One last point, how to deploy a new version of a single microservice? Will all the instances be shut down at the same time or one by one? When deploying with ECS, I can choose the deploy strategy. I have the rolling update, the blue-green, and the external deploy. The rolling update will update instance by instance until the last one. I can specify the percentage of instances I want to keep up during the process and how many new instances I allow to create. The blue-green strategy is only available by using code deploy. It will deploy instances with the new version and redirect some traffic to the new instances and some traffic to the old instances. This way I can go back if needed. Finally, the external deploy is a fine-tuning tool. It allows me to manually manipulate all the services, tasks, and load balancers. I've not seen a case where this can be interesting. Let's go now with 4 easy steps to deploy my microservices architecture to AWS ECS. I will start by creating the load balancer to access my microservices. For that, I need 2 services, the load balancer, of course, and the target group. Let's start with the target group. The target group will have registered each microservice, and it will check if it's healthy or not to redirect the traffic to it. Then the load balancer will receive external traffic and redirect it to the available instances in the target group. I choose to use the target group with instances. Pick a name, the port and the protocol I will use. Make sure it's the same used in the load balancer. For the VPC, I will choose an already created VPC, as done in a previous video. Which endpoint to test the application? I've created an endpoint named Health. Continue to the next step. As there is no running instances at the moment, I will skip this part. Let's continue now with the load balancer. I choose to create an application load balancer. I put the name first. Here's where I say that my load balancer will have public access. Leave the EPv4 option. Select my VPC with almost 2 public subnets. And choose an already created security group, as done in a previous video. And finally, which ports are open in the load balancer and the forward to my previous target group. And create it. Let's continue creating the ECS cluster, the EC2 instances where all my microservices will run. Let's first pick a name. I leave the on-demand option. Choose the instance type. I pick the T2 micro, which is a small and free instance. I want two instances for now. I leave the default image. And no SSH key, as I don't need to log into those instances. Again, the same VPC. Select a public subnet. Enable the auto-assigned IP. And select my security group. That's it. Click on Create and wait until the two instances are running. Before creating my tasks, before defining how to deploy a microservice instance, I will create a Docker repository where to push a Docker image of my microservice. To create a repository, make sure it's private. Then pick a name. Once created, I have the push commands here. Let's go now to the task definition. As always, first pick a name. I don't need any role for this task, as I won't use any AWS API. Leave the network mode to the default value. Leave those blank, I will fill them later. Finally, here I choose my Docker image. Here I define how much memory and CPU will consume this task, this service. I will only allocate 256 MB. Choose which port to use in the Docker image. And also allocate 256 CPU units. I will leave the rest of the options with the default values. That's all, let's create my task. I will first show how to deploy a service from the AWS console, and later I will do it again from a terminal, as done from a CI/CD platform. So let's now deploy my microservice to ECS. From the task definition, I can see a revision. A single version of my microservice. Each new version I want to deploy needs a new revision. Now I go to the ECS cluster and create a service based on the previous task revision. I choose the task definition and the latest revision. The name of my service. How many instances I want to start of my microservice? Let's say 2. And choose the deployment strategy. I choose 100% healthy and can reach 200% maximum. The rolling update strategy. And continue to the next step. I will choose now the load balancer. And my target group. Here is the health check I've created before. And continue. And now the policies to auto-scale my microservice. I want the CPU to be around 50%. If needed, create until 10 instances. And never less than 2. Leave the rest with the default values and create. Now I can check the service status in the Event tab. Here I can see my microservice is now stable. Now that my service is deployed and stable, I can test it. I must go back to the load balancer to pick the URL to request. As it's the only available entry point. Here it is. It's the response of my microservice deployed in ECS. But my microservice architecture must be adapted to the load. I already have the number of instances which increases automatically. But what if the actual cluster is not enough? I need my ECS cluster to autoscale if too many instances are launched at the same time. When I've created my ECS cluster, a launch configuration was also created, with the same information of the EC2 instances already created, the AMEI, the instance type, the security group, and more. An autoscaling group was also created, but I will edit it to be more dynamic. I want always almost two instances. In case of an instance stops, I always have another one running, and maximum never more than 10 instances. Otherwise, it will be too expensive. Let's save. Okay, all my microservice architecture is ready, deployed on ECS and ready to scale up if more load is received. But how do I update my microservice with a new version from a CI/CD platform? I must first push a new Docker image with a new version, then create a new task revision based on the task definition, and finally update the existing service with the new revision. Let's see the commands. Let's go now creating a new revision. I assume the terminal which runs the command have the AWS CLI configured and connected to the AWS account. I first need to create a new revision of my task definition. Let's do it with the following command. This identifies the task definition. This is the ID of the created execution role by AWS. Here are the settings of my container with the link to my latest Docker image. And now let's update the running service with this new revision with this command. Here is the name of my cluster. This is the name I want for my service. Here I indicate how many instances I want of my service. This is the task definition with the latest revision and the deployment configuration, the maximum percentage and the minimum healthy percentage. This is to indicate that I want my deployment to be effective as soon as possible. Okay, let's go with a quick recap. I've created an ECS cluster with two instances which will contain the services deployed. I've created a load balancer to have a single entry point and redirect all the requests to all my existing services. I've created a task definition for my microservice and a revision with the latest version from a Docker image. I've deployed my microservice in the cluster, specifying the rollout strategy. I've created the autoscaling routes for my cluster and for my service. And finally, I've identified the commands to use from a CI/CD pipeline to update my existing microservice with a new version. That's all for this video. I hope all the components and steps are clear enough. Don't hesitate to watch again the video to make sure you understand all the AWS services I've used. And now click on the like button, subscribe to my channel, and see you soon. Bye!